NOVDEC 2020, question number 10, this on statistics. The table shows the distribution of the ages of pupils in a particular school. So we have ages in years, number of pupils. Now we have been told to calculate correct one decimal place. The mean is, the B is standard deviation, and then the mean deviation. Now what is so important is that we have to draw a table, but then we have to know the formula because the formulas will help us draw the table. Now the mean, the formula for the mean is giving us, that is sigma fx all over sigma f. And then our standard deviation, the formula is square root, that is sigma fx square all over sigma f minus the mean square. Minus the mean square. And then our mean deviation is equal to sigma fx minus the mean all over sigma f. So with this, this will help us to draw our table. So we have, that is ages in years. So probably let's say the ages in years is x. And then our frequent number of people, that is frequency, that's f. And for us to get the mean, then we need fx. And then beneath it, that will give us the sigma fx. So this will give us that. Now, after that, for us to get the standard deviation, so this will give us the mean. This will give us the mean. Now, the standard deviation, you need fx square. So the next thing is to find the square of the ages. And then the next one, fx square. So beneath here, we can get our sigma fx square. So this will give us the standard deviation. Now, how can you get the mean deviation? Now you have x minus the mean and then f times it. So here we can see this x minus the mean, absolute of the x minus the mean. And then the last one will be f times the absolute of x minus the mean. Now what are ages? That's 3 to 10. So we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now let's rule our lines through. Now what are our frequencies? Our frequencies, we have 9, 8, 5, 6, 2, 4. We have to be very careful that everything is correct. 9, 8, 5, 6, 2, 4. So our fx, that is 3 times 9, that will be 27. 4 times 8, this is 32. 5, this will give us 25. 6, that is 36. 7 times 5, and this will give us, that is 35. 8 times 6, and this would, 8 times 6, that is 48. 9 times 2, we have 18. 10 times 4, that is 40. So beneath here, so sigma fx, that is addition of everything here, and then sigma fx, this is giving us, that is 261, that is our sigma fx. Now x square, we have to square the x. So 3 square, 9, 4 square, 16, 5 square, 25, 6 square, 36, 7 square, 49, 8 square, 64, 9 square, 81, 10 square, we have 100. Now, this one says fx square. So f times the x square. So you have 9 times 9, that is 81. 8 times 16, that is 128. 128. And then 5 times 25, that is 125. Now 6 times 36, 6 times 36, this is giving us, that is 216. Now 5 times 49. 5 times 49, that is 245. And then 6 times 64, that is 384. And then 2 times 81, that is 162. And then 4 times 100, this is 400. So this will give us our sigma F x squared. When you add all, that will be 1741. Now, the first one says that we have to find our mean. So our mean is giving us, that is sigma fx all over sigma f. And then, what is our sigma fx? Our sigma fx is 261. What is our sigma f? Addition sigma f, that is addition of everything over here. And this is equal to 45. So over 45. And when you work out this, this is equal to 5.8. This is our A. Now let's see our B. Our B says that you find the standard deviation. And our standard deviation is equal to the square root of sigma f x squared all over sigma f minus the mean square. And this we have square root of, now what is sigma f x squared? Sigma f x squared is 1741. You have to be very careful. This is what confuses students. They write this and then they square it. No. The sigma f x squared is what we found here. The addition of everything under f x squared. That's sigma f x squared, 1741. All over sigma f, and then our sigma f is 45. Minus the mean square. In this case, we know the mean already. The mean is 5.8. So you can just put 5.8 all square. Or you can put the 261 over the 45. But you still get the same thing. And when we do this, we are going to get, that is 2.24697. We have to punch on the calculator. But then the question says that correct to one decimal place. So correct to one decimal place, that is 2.2. That's just 2.2. Now the next one is for us to find the mean deviation. If you've not subscribed, please make sure that you do that. Now we're on the mean deviation, but then we need x minus the mean. Now we know that the mean is 5.8, so our x is 3. Now, so here, that would be 3, x is 3, and then our mean is 5.8, so 3 minus, that is 5.8, that's negative 2.8, but because of the absolute, to make it positive, so that would be, this would be 2.8. Now, the next one is 4 minus the mean, that would be negative 1, but because of the absolute, it would be positive 1.8. Now, 5 minus 5.8, that's negative 0.8, but because of the absolute, to make it positive, that's 0.8. And then we have 6 minus 5.8, and this is just 0.2. Now we have 7 minus 5.8, because the mean is 5.8. And when you do that, this is just 1.2. Now, 8 minus 5.8, and this is just 2.2. Now, 9 minus 5.8. And this is just 3.2. And then 10 minus 5.8. And this is just 4.2. Now, we want to find this one. That is f times x minus the mean. What is our f? 9. So 9 times 2.8. And this is just 25.2. Now, we have x. F. That is f. So 8 times 1.8, and this is just 14.4. And then the next one, 5 times 0.8, this is 4. And then 6 times 0.2, there's 1.2. And then we have 5 times 1.2, and this is just 6, and then we have 6 times 2.2, and this is just 13.2. We have 2 times 3.2, that is 6.4, and then we have 4 times 4.2, that is 16.8. Hence, beneath this, this way we can get our sigma f, that is x minus the mean, addition of everything here, and when you add all, we are getting that is 87.2. Now, our mean deviation, that is sigma f, x minus the mean absolute, all over sigma f. Now, our sigma f, x minus the mean, that is summation of that, is giving us 87.2. So we have 87.2 all over our sigma f. Our sigma f is giving us, that is 45. And when we do this on a calculator, this is just giving us 1.93778. But then the question says one decimal place. One decimal place, that'll be 1.9. That's one decimal place.